Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays the Binding of Isaac. I guess we're due for a random, this is always the fingers crossed one. No lost, Isaac maybe. Alright, that's okay. We had an Isaac run two runs ago that went totally fine. Curse of the Unknown, not that big of a deal. Y2VV3Z60. Super Gluttony fight right off the bat might be awesome as well. We're rolling with a pretty incredible streak right now, and you know, I think I'm feeling like I'm hitting that equilibrium where it's like insane runs that are also wins. Like that's what's feeling good. I've been throwing away one runs to potentially, oh, that's pretty good, to potentially lose runs, but still pulling out wins on it. Not to say that I'm playing particularly amazingly, you know, the game has been kind. Now I'm a little concerned about our HP. Like the lard pickup only gives us a half heart, so it's a bit of a wild spot here, but I don't think we're gonna find ourselves in too bad of a spot unless we take more damage and fight the Haunt. But anyway, or we fight like Blighted Ovum and just suck, which can also happen, but this is an interesting little fuck corridor down here. A lot of people have asked me over the years, what is a fuck corridor? This is pretty much the raw definition right there, and you know, oh baby, I like it raw. Oh baby, I like it raw. We got another one down here. I don't know if I've ever seen this room before, weirdly enough. It's amazing that there's still rooms that are rare enough that I've never seen them, or at least I've seen them so little that it feels like I've never seen them. There we go. Pull out a whole penny out of that. That's pretty amazing. What do we got in here? That's a bit of a weird one. Spider Baby is obviously better than Book of Sin if we have a spacebar item that we're already quite fond of. So in the way, I basically traded Spider Baby for a bomb. Is that a good trade? Nah, we probably would have rather had Spider Baby than have a bomb. Like a single bomb. In this situation at least. However, it's not like we traded a decent passive item for a consumable. We traded a shitty passive item, relatively shitty at least, for a consumable, so I'm not that bent out of shape about it. It was a moderate risk, it didn't pan out for us, shit happens. Duke of Flies, totally easy boss fight here. I am gonna use a bomb. Really had to hit with it, otherwise I would have felt pretty bad that we used a bomb that we could have used to get a spirit heart on the next floor, potentially. But hopefully we'll like get a bomb somehow before it becomes relevant, or we just won't take damage on the next floor. Either way, I would be content with it. I don't really mind if we get hit here, but I'd prefer not to, if given the option at least. There we go. Pick that up. Should put us close to full HP, maybe not quite at it, depending how much damage that Gluttony did to us. And Placenta's fine. We're gonna be at something stupid, like maybe even 7? No, I think we're at 6 HP. Well, we won't know. Well, we started with 3, and then we picked up Lard, which is 2 containers anyway, and then we picked up Placenta, which is 1, so I think we're at 7. There's a Tinted Rock right there. We should, I mean, remember, mark it on our map. Tinted Rock right there. Hopefully we can get some advantageous advantages out of this. Ah! I don't know what happened. My brain actually froze a little bit. That one was a little bit shittier, but for real, I was like, I'm gonna get hit by that. You should move. But the message never actually made its way to my fingers. Is the... We gotta check that out next time we see an ooze guy. I believe that the ooze is like the exact same graphic, or sprite, I guess, as Mom's wig, just with a different color and maybe like one line of shade on it. I'm taking Epic Fetus, because I'm mad about the damage that I took. We can get synergies with Epic Fetus, which is what I'm hoping for, but beyond that, I'm just really thankful to have Epic Fetus because it's a great item and will probably win us the game by itself. Very dangerous idea right there. You might be a little perturbed by this, but I very usually when I get Epic Fetus, it's like later and I already have a good foundation for a run and I don't want to just spoil it by being like a try-hard dickbag. In this situation, I'm very happy to get Epic Fetus. Not so concerned about Unicorn Stump. At least with our current combination, but at least we got a free crawl space, that's nice. And we'll see if we can still swing our first deal with the devil here, although I'm a little skeptical. Probably should not be dodging right into my own Epic Fetus shots. I'm starting to get a little concerned, actually, that maybe I will find myself in a difficult situation here. It's always difficult when you have Epic Fetus as well to balance, like, should I be an ultimate tryhard or should I just get the win? But that Able pickup, oh man, that's huge. That means we're gonna have the occasional bullet being fired. Could change the game here. Inside of our curse room, spirit, hearts. All right. Nailed it. 10 out of 10 on that prediction. We're up to 13 cents. Very easily could get to 15 for our shop just by blowing up our donation machine or, you know, probably like that pot that's in there. Spirit hearts. Okay. Every time I say spirit hearts, we don't get spirit hearts. It is not lost on me. I'll tell you what, though. We'll pick this up. Early Pandora's box doesn't really appeal to me that much right now. I think you get, like, on this floor, you get, like, four consumables. You get, like, two keys, two bombs. It's not bad, per se. Another Tinted Rock. The game has been kind, and finally we get a Spirit Heart out of that one. Did we miss a... We might have missed a Tinted Rock somewhere else on this level, but, it's okay. Second secret room? Had to be. And we'll blow this up and hopefully pick up some more red hearts, actually. More money for the future floors. All right, that's meaningful. But for now, just excited that we're going to be done with this. We won't have a reroll ready, but I guess that's not really as big of a concern considering we're going to be, like, two-shotting every boss. We still could get a deal with the devil. Remember, we did take red heart damage, but we haven't taken red heart damage against the boss, so we have a spirit heart backing us up. Not very good predictive aiming there. No, okay, we got squeezy, which is fine. A little bit of faster rate of fire. Now I'm looking for stuff like, you know... Quad shot. Quad shot, Loki's horns, stuff like that would be amazing. But I'm mostly just happy that it looks like this Isaac run is going to be relatively easy, and hopefully we can get some interesting synergies to go along with it. But from just like a self-preservation standpoint, I'm pleased. That's right, don't move. Don't move, don't move, don't move. Got him. The biggest risk for us is enemies that don't... they locomote too quickly, right? So it's very difficult for us to aim. Enemies that pop under the ground, like Polycephalus, is going to be a total asshole. But apart from that, I think pretty much there's nothing stopping us from snagging an easy win here. Petrified poop is... I mean, at this point, I'm struggling to bring some drama to the commentary. Will he or won't he win the game in under 30 minutes? Like, Epic Fetus is kind of a gift from the heavens. Most of the time, I choose not to take it. I made the different decision this time. And I have to admit, this is like a lot of runs in a row where we've had Mom's Knife, Guppy, Epic Fetus, Brimstone. Like, just top-tier items that shit on everything else. Eventually, we're going to have to build a run out of some kind of more dubious pieces. But as of right now... I'm just happy to, you know, get that streak number ticking up, and hopefully we can... You know what would be awesome is if we got Epic Fetus, but then, like, on the last floor, we got, like, a one room. Reroll our whole run into something stupid and crazy and still good. Think about it. Think about it. Should be able to take out this guy relatively easily. The other thing is we need more speed. Lard, much to my surprise, I looked it up because Kate was right about this. Despite playing less Rebirth than me, she knows more about it. Which is just something you should say anyway, because she's my wife and happy wife, happy life. However, it's actually true in this case as well. She was like, why do you not like Small Rock that much? Like, you never sound excited when you... I don't know why I took on that tone of voice. But she's like, you never sound that excited when you pick up Small Rock. You should, because it gives you as much damage as the Pact does. I was like, oh shit. Is she right? And it turns out she was right. The Pact or the Mark, I can't remember. It's one of the two. I'm excited for both of those. And then she was like, I don't like Lard as much because it's a speed downgrade. And I was like, no, it was a speed downgrade in vanilla, but it's not a speed downgrade anymore. It totally still is a speed downgrade. It's a smaller one. It's like 0.2 or something like that. But still, it is a speed downgrade. Weird, huh? Dead Onion does nothing for us. But I'm going to take it. And it might seem stupid, but I'm going to take it just so I have a reroll ready for what is basically a guaranteed deal with the devil here. And I think it's more important that we make sure our deals with the devil are optimized than our item room items are optimized. We could be looking for crawl spaces, but to be honest with you, I think crawl space meta, that's something for the lost, man. Crawl space and black market. It's just not that important on other characters because they're usually kind of bad. Like, I can't remember the last time I had a really good crawl space. Admittedly, Unicorn Stump is a pretty good crawl space that we just can't really take advantage of because of the character that we are and the items that we start with. But apart from that, it's been a long time. Okay, we will check out our shop, obviously. Little Baggy's just a little shitty. And we'll get ready to use our Telepills. I'm not necessarily thinking we'll use it for Boss Rush, although, you know, I gotta be honest, that is on my mind a little bit. We'll see. No second secret room there. Okay. Let's do it up. Peep should be easy. He jumps. That's going to be a little tricky, but as long as we time our shots right, should be a very simple finish. So I'm not very worried about Guppy. I'm mostly worried about ability to fly, speed, extra damage, anything like that we can stack up is awesome. I don't know, Abaddon maybe is like an endgame beloved item or something we could take here. Judas of Shadow, I'll reroll. Yeah, fuck it, let's take 9 lives. Even though I said I wasn't interested in Guppy, I'm interested in this. I'm interested in our implications from taking 9 lives, because with Epic Fetus, plus 9 lives, that gives us a huge ability to win this run. If we didn't have it already, basically, the reason I love 9 lives is because it gives you that possibility to... Oh, that's why I rerolled it, and it turned out I probably would have been better off not rerolling it. But anyway, if you have enough damage, it doesn't matter how much HP you have. That's the kind of, like, law that I adhere to. We have a ton of damage, just by virtue of Epic Fetus giving us a fuck ton of damage. Not any more elegant way to put it than that. So basically, I'm not gonna be concerned about the fact that I lost like 5 HP with that pickup. Because although I lost 5 HP, I gained a lot of like late game potential. Plus now we have Deal with the Devil precedent, plus now we have a chance to become Guppy, and we'll at least learn whether or not that helps us with Epic Fetus. We know we have 1 HP thanks to Curse of the Unknown. Or thanks to the Guppy pickup. Oh, we just got a little HP back there from Placenta, I guess. I'm glad we stayed in there for one more play. That extra dime could end up giving us like a mom's key or something like that. And there's our regular secret room, I think. No, second secret room. So we shouldn't play the blood bank anymore, but that's okay. Full health. I found pills. And luck down. At least we knew that full health was in there. Alright, so that's our second secret room, which tells me that the boss room is probably like a right hook here, like down here. Then hook right, and then come back up and around, I think, maybe. I may be 100% freaking wrong with that. I thought you were a silkworm shooter, so that damage is on me. I will admit that the amazing amount of curses of the unknown we're getting right now are giving me pause, man. I'm freaking out a little bit. Do we have enough spirit hearts to go into our curse room? I don't know. I'm hoping. Oh, well, there's not going to be a secret room there, so I'm not going to gain any advantage out of it that way. Careful. Oh, God. Should not have done that in that situation. But hematemesis, huh? We're already at full HP because we only have 1. It's unfortunate, but I guess we buy the spirit heart, reroll, probably take Steam Sail, even though we're on Catacombs 2. At least by buying the spirit... Well, we might as well throw this down here. Maybe we get Dark Bomb or something. This will be a nice room. But by buying that spirit heart, we do guarantee ourselves the ability to come in here without dying as long as we don't get hit. And it worked out. That's why you want to do it. We could have telepills out of boss rush instead, but I figured let's give the people a break here. You're already watching what's probably going to be a one run. We don't need to twist the knife that much further. We got telepills again anyway. And we got a health upgrade, which is awesome. So now we can make use of this full health pill. And we got 2 telepills, actually. Yeah, let's use a bomb there. Certainly, how else would I explode this door if I didn't use the magical mercurial powers of an explosive device? I can't even imagine. Are you a wizard? This room is actually like my kryptonite here, but if I go crazy, will you still call me Superman? If I'm alive and well, will you be there holding my hand? I'll keep you by my side with my superhuman might, kryptonite. What does that song even mean? I mean, I've gone on record as saying I'm not the biggest Three Doors Down fan in the universe. However, Kryptonite, their most popular song, I just don't get it. That's another full health pill, I think. Figured if the flies didn't die, we would just make sure they died. I can't even think of like a song meaning for that. Is it about, because all pop songs, even like pop rock songs, they always end up being about relationships anyway, right? Or just once I'd like to hear like a pop song that's about pizza. You know, it's always about, do you love me? Do you love me? Where's the, I'll have a pepperoni, I'll have an olive, I'll have a pineapple, and then get some breadsticks. Like, I know that it needs some punching up, you know? That song doesn't necessarily have a huge hook to it right now, but I could see that being the next big sensation. I spend as much time thinking about pizza as I do about relationships. That's not true. I spend more time thinking about pizza. And that's probably why my relationship works so well. Because we're both thinking about pizza all the time. What could go wrong? Thank God we got Sister Maggie there. That's an extremely valuable item. I guess we're going to go... In a weird way, I'm feeling like this run is strangely underpowered. It's kind of not, because we have 9 lives, a lot of HP, epic fetus. But it could be stronger. Let's just put it that way. And it, in a weird way, epic fetus almost has like a limiter attached to it. Like, it can't get that much stronger than it starts as because of the extreme penalty to your rate of fire. Now, it can hit multiple enemies at the same time. That's dependent on your aim, though. But a room like this would be a lot faster with just like piercing shots or Mom's Knife or Brimstone in particular. But that's why, like, principally, this is why epic fetus doesn't really qualify for me as one of my very, very, very top items in the game. Maybe. Like, is it top 1 or 2? No. That's about it. It was probably number 1 in vanilla. I think Brimstone and Mom's Knife might both beat it now. Of course, if we wanted to, we could just straight up leave every single room we came to until we came to the item rooms, bosses, and shops. And that would probably speed up the whole process a little bit, but you lose a lot of the fun in that as well. At least I feel like you lose a lot of the fun in that as well. But if you wanted to speedrun it, I guess that's how you'd do it. Oh, there you are. Okay. Like, in a way, I find it hard to believe that we're only on depths 1. Like, this room is also going to be kind of annoying, except... In the rare situation that we have, like, literally all of the enemies drop on us simultaneously. That's very helpful. No greed fight. And we just got the same bullshit items over and over. I wish we didn't, but we do. Pretty excited about I found pills. That's a really good one. Let's do our next big room, I guess. What am I hoping for on this run? Like, I want... Epic fetus shots that kill everything in one hit. We're not quite there. It's a realistic goal for epic fetus, so I don't think we should feel bad about asking for it. Cool synergies, and also like tiers upgrades, because right now I'm not shooting quickly enough to really feel as strong as I am. 2 of hearts, man, that is not what I'm looking for. Telepills will allow us to get into boss rush, which at this point I want to do just to get some sweet synergies, which is what I always say, and the main reason you go to boss rush is so you have a choice in your destiny. Okay, this is good. Midas Touch, we could have had a Midas Touch Unicorn Stump run. Theoretically, at least. 5, that's a forget-me-now. So I'll tell you what, we will do this. I think it is for the best. 5 is actually quickly becoming maybe my favorite out of all the, out of all the pip rooms, like the dice rooms, because it's objectively great. Giving you an extra floor, it's basically saying like this dice room preserves your current run, which you might be quite fond of because with the D6 you built it yourself, and then you have the ability to just get one extra everything tacked on top of it. Now this will fuck up our boss rush ability, but this is about where my value proposition hews, I think. Like, the ability to get one whole extra floor is definitely worth more than a boss rush. One item room, one shop. Stars, Temperance, High Priestess. We can make use of our Temperance card. That's probably not worth it. Oh, what? I used Telepills instead. Alright, that's... I thought that was Temperance. My mistake. Well, now we've totally fucked boss rush, so we should just keep going. But, yeah, like, that adds up to be more than the sum of its parts for sure. Or did I? No, I used the stars card. Sorry, not telepills. I was holding a card. I just didn't look at what it was. Stupid. So we can stick with telepills if we would so desire. Other one was High Priestess, I think. Yeah. We'll fight our boss and then we'll get ready to do the floor all over again. What was I thinking there? Like, let's just be honest. That was ridiculously dumb. So I'm hoping for a deal with the devil here and then a deal with the devil here. Leads to a good reroll. Maybe we have a good chance to become Guppy. Hopefully we get a deal with the devil on the next floor as well. Cage is still going to be annoying, man. Because Cage is always annoying. We got him about 60% done. If he never jumps again, we might be able to kill him within the next, like, 5 seconds. Oh, it's dangerous. Yep, shot him right into myself, but Midas Touch finished the job there. Really, no deal with the devil? Pentagram, though. So I thought with the pentagram, if we walked in and out, we might be able to snag a deal with the devil just by being, you know, lucky. Maybe a little bit of wishful thinking on my part there. But we went to our item room. We went to our shop. We'll now reroll the shit out of everything. Could, I mean, we might as well have used that two of hearts. I wanted that red heart before you... I should have shot it with Epic Fetus. That's my bad. All right, so we'll do Dwayne the Rock Johnson in the butt first. I don't know where my mind went to on that one. Oh, you know what? I have a tab open in the background, and on the side, it was like, Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Because I just Google him from time to time. Just to see how he's doing, you know? Call me Dwayne. Can't fly, so we can't get over there. Boss rush is definitely not going to happen. However, hopefully by doing this floor, we can actually come back and... There's a tinted rock there I didn't see. Hopefully by doing this floor, we can come back, get another deal with the devil. And again, maybe have a good chance to become Guppy. That would sort us out, give us the ability to fly. Put your arms around me, baby. Put your arms around me, baby. All the songs about flying. You know what? Lenny Kravitz deserves some credit. I'm pretty sure his magnum opus, Fly, is not about a relationship. It's about, I want to get away, I want to fly away. It's mostly about JetBlue. Yara, that's what we want. Death Tower, yeah, Yara. I mean, there was nothing I was going to take instead of Yara permanently, but temporarily there was a chance. Oh, we can create a bridge there. I had no idea, to be honest with you. Devil, Moon, Yara. Let's not fuck this up. We got to create a bridge still. I mean, I knew that there was the principle of creating a bridge here. I just didn't think we would be able to do it with this limited amount of space. We don't... What is going on here? Two of Spades. Where's the Two of Spades card? It's deeper in there. Ah! I need the Two of Spades card. Okay, now just get out of there. Fuck the Two of Hearts. Just go. You earned it. Here's a little tip for you. Some people might not have known that you could... you probably knew you could create a bridge with bombs. I didn't know you could actually shove the Epic Fetus shot so far back there that it would create a bridge, even though it, you know, there's no full tile in order to draw from. Weird. Tears down. That is a huge... I mean, it's not a huge problem. It's just a major disappointment. Because that's one of the principal things I'm looking for is tears upgrades. Definitely up there for, like, most enemies killed with a single shot right now. Item room is Lemon Mishap. Halo! Okay, starting to feel better about that. I don't know why this run feels strangely underpowered, man. I don't really want to go to our shop with so little money. Keys are not, balling out of control right now. Could be a Joker card. Two of Hearts. That was an incredibly fast shot there. Well, it's a shame we're not going for me, boy. Because we might have had a decent chance at it here. Now that I think about it, that's one of the stupidest things I've ever said in Isaac. We have zero cubes of meat. But in my head, I was like, but we had a chance to get more of them. We might as well explore a little bit more. We've taken so little time on this floor. That's obviously not our second secret room, but this could be. Yeah. That could end up being very valuable. Two spiders, man. You don't know what the spider economy is like right now, so those could be like the fucking boot jalokia peppers of the spider world, so don't tell me that they're worthless. You don't know that yet. I gotta admit that I'm a little bit underwhelmed with this run. I hope that one of the reasons people watch me is that, you know, I'm not afraid to, you know, call it like I see it here. This run is a little bit of a more boring run. It's not just because of Epic Fetus. You know, we could have had Unicorn Stump, Midas Touch. That's a little bit more exciting, but... I would have had to get rid of the D6 for Unicorn Stump. Be honest out there, how many of you would have given up the D6 for Unicorn Stump on the first floor? I don't think that many people would have actually gone through with it. So I don't feel that bad about that. I know I said I was going to explore more. I think now that we found the secret room and the second secret room, I'm kind of like, I'm done, man. I'm mostly just pissed off that we can't seem to get any deals with the devil, despite the fact that I'm doing these things that should, you know, conceivably give me a lot of deal with the devil potential. But whatever. We got the Halo on this floor. We got a cube of meat. We sing the songs that remind us of the good times. We sing the songs that remind us of the best times. Let's head down to the next floor. Not really nervous about the way that this is going, but I really don't want to be the guy who loses the epic fetus run, you know? I'm much happier being the guy who, like, through some kind of stroke of fate, kind of beat the lost on his first couple of tries. Well, some of his first couple of tries. As opposed to the guy that's a wizard. Health up, that's a good one. And another wizard pill. I got a reputation to sort of maintain. We got five, oh my god. First off, we got magic mushroom. Secondly, we got five fucking pills out of five mushrooms. That's extremely rare. Lucky us. The mushroom pickup there is the big one, obviously, but still. I guess maybe we don't need a tears upgrade to shoot faster. Maybe we need a shot speed upgrade. Anything that makes the bombs fall from the sky faster. Or maybe there's nothing that makes the bombs fall from the sky faster. Now, admittedly, we could use the hematemesis pill to get into that... oh, this is pretty good. We could use that hematemesis pill to get into the... boss room? And was there another full health pill in that secret room? There might have been. That would be worthwhile. Give us a better chance of that guppy situation. There we go. Look at the ooze. I'm telling you, man, that ooze is mom's wig. They repurposed it, man. It's so close. I'm on to you, Ed. Maybe not that one. That one looks a little lumpier. There's no extra full health pill in there. It's the orange one. If we find one, though, we can take advantage of it. For now, just kind of good. Basically, I walk into a room. I'm playing, like, Plants vs. Zombies right now, which is not meant as an insult to Plants vs. Zombies, which I think is a great game. But, like, the sun is popping up, and I'm, like, painting my mouse over it right now, being like, ooh, I'm getting points. Like, I'm just painting my mouse over every single enemy that pops into the game. Ooh, points. Tell you what. We'll use hematemesis. There's enough HP that I feel relatively safe. Two HP is apparently the amount that I need. I think we're gonna take like all of this. We have 9 lives anyway. Goathead could be valuable. I think that will give us extra damage, like Death's Touch will give us extra damage there. And we'll reroll that into Ceremonial Robe, so that feels pretty good. And then for one red chest, I'll open this shit up, sure, why not? Oh yeah, okay, our damage is actually really, really good now. Not quite one-shotting, but you know, Magic Mushroom, Ceremonial Robes, Death's Touch is a... that's a big win for us. It's a boon, if you will. Please stop jumping. There we go. Oh, punched my microphone. Still getting used to my new desk setup here. And now we don't even need the HP because we traded it all away. It's the perfect crime. It was the perfect crime. Alright, that is... an interesting champion there. I figured he would explode. Maybe he did, but because I exploded him, it didn't look like he exploded. So this has been a crazy floor so far. We've already gotten Humbling Bundle, Death's Touch, Ceremonial Robes. I'm not doing this for dramatic effect, I'm just trying to remember. The Nail, which we then traded away. And there was one more in there that I've forgotten about now, but was conceivably pretty good because I picked it up right off the bat. Goathead, right, Goathead. Okay, so Goathead pretty much just guarantees us a deal with the devil on the next floor, assuming it's not an XL floor, which may or may not be that meaningful, but pretty soon, despite having so few deals with the devil, I think we're gonna have all of the deal with the devil items in the game spoken for, which is a joke, but in every joke there's a little bit of reality, right? That was a very smart idea on my part there. Normally I wouldn't take this, but because I have Midas Touch, I think that these, well, it's pretty nice. I think these work in synergy, like in concert with one another, to do more contact damage. I hope that's the case. And then if we ever find like a Unicorn Horn or a Celtic Cross or a Book of Shadows or something like that, then we can try to roll with that strategy instead of just nonstop Epic Fetus nonsense, right? Please don't make me do this 4 times. I've still got to kill these jerk holes. It was worth it for the black heart, though. It's kind of a long floor here. Kind of a long run, considering we picked up Epic Fetus on our second floor item room. But that's okay. Who would have thought that the Epic Fetus run would be the one where I can't pick up, or I can't do boss rush? Not great play from me there. I'm just gonna go. This is actually gonna be a little tricky. There we go. We only need to land like 4 shots, so it shouldn't be that tough. Oh, we got small rock out of that too? I didn't even see that tinted rock, so that's pretty amazing to me. Really smart play there. Come on, come on, come on. I'm so out of sync here, but I don't know how to fix it. There we go. Alright, now deal with the devil, which we've already dealt with. And down to the next floor. This Yarrow rune is huge. Small rock helps out a lot. I can't imagine what our like damage stat is right now. It has to be insane. So single target foes that don't spawn minions are like our dream weavers right now. Ooh, that probably should have hit me. What pisses me off is enemies that have multiple segments. Like this guy, for example, is gonna be a little annoying. Samson's lock. Yeah, let's just blow up the guy who gave us free HP. Smart idea there. Samson's lock, I don't know. I like Liberty Cap for the map and compass effects we occasionally get. One more hit here should do it. And this is a deal with the devil and a very, very fast floor as well. Of course, my dream is if we could become Guppy, that would be crazy. Just die? That was like super easy. No tinted rocks that I can see. And experimental treatment's a wild one. Hmm. We got a spirit heart. So we'll reroll experimental treatment. I was up to pick it up, but if I can reroll it into something that's way better for me, then I'm going to be way more excited to do so. Alrighty then. Can't go into that room, somewhat unfortunately. Now it's all about this Yarrow room, though. That's the star of the show. Whoa, we got a little larger there. That's what happens when you start working from home. A little bit of a self-deprecating joke there. You know what? I don't like that room. Any room where I have to fight like a huge amounts of just raw enemies? Yeah, no, I'm not that interested. I'll trade 2 hearts to come in here and get 2 hearts. Didn't know I was gonna get 2 hearts, but I'll get 2 hearts. I think our area of effect is like a little longer than, or a little larger than I thought it would be for the Epic Fetus shot, so I'm very thankful for that. Yeah, we can actually hit all 4, that time 5 units. What if the area of effect is tied to the range of the item? Or the, like, our range stat? If so, that's actually really cool. So it looks like we'll probably have to go back through that room. Could have totally gone in here for free. Blank card Yarrow rune, huh? I think I might go for it. Now, we only have 8 keys. So we might want to start, like, blank card Yarrowing. Oh my god, is that, like, 2 Yarrow runes here? No, Hagalaz. Let's take Hagalaz in here. We might want to start blank card Yarrowing like a room full of keys on this floor or on the cathedral. I'll start doing it here just because it's easy enough. And if we could pick up like 32 keys, I'd feel pretty good about it. But blank card Yarrow, obviously, it's better the longer, like the more keys we can get out of it. If we can get 99 out of it, that'd be even better. That I assume is just obvious. I don't think we ever have to come through this room again. Did we actually turn an enemy into golden poop? Oh, dude, it would be so cool if that's actually how it worked. Like, if you had Midas Touch and Turdy Touch, it turned enemies into golden poop. I mean, it does turn them into golden poop, but if it turned them into golden poop and gave you the requisite rewards... What the hell happened there? Can someone explain that one to me? I mean, I can explain it, actually. We didn't kill the enemy that grabbed us. I don't think there's any reason to double this room instead. Yeah, we couldn't kill the enemy that grabbed us. This room is fucked up, man. It's actually good for us, if we have to walk on the spikes. As long as we can just finish the room. There we go, okay. Could have started doubling this. Doesn't really matter, though. We already have a room full of 2 keys. So let's come back, and then we'll double those 4 keys to 8s. No, it's 2 keys to 4, sorry. Next one will be 4 keys to 8. Hoping that maybe... Oh, you know what? What do we need money for at this point in our lives, right? Oh, it broke on the first one? That's kind of sad. as is that. I don't really care to play our blood bank, honestly. Smart play right there. Again, though, I'm basically like 9 lives makes it so that if I die, it doesn't matter. It's kind of a cheeky way to look at it, but it's also true. Like, we're not basically at any risk at all. Half red heart. Okay. Curse of the Maze, I guess. One's dead. Two is dead? It's like a half second too fast there. Too slow, I guess. He was a half second too fast. Don't charge. Don't move. Alright, one more and then we'll have 8 keys. I'm still hoping to get, like, I mean, 99 might be a little bit of a pipe dream here. Oh, that helps, though. I mean, it helps not very much, because we're about to double 4 to 8 and then 8 to 16, but it helps a little bit. And we can always do this on the cathedral, if we have to. And if we want to, for that matter. I would like to beat Mom's heart before dying. Oh, I can't get that. I might be able to, but it's probably not worth the risk just for one key. Alright, so it's gonna be up here. I hope that we get at least one more doubling. Like, 16 keys is a start. Ah, shit. Might as well just go back and pick it up. It's possible we might get, like, a battery charge or something like that, but I think it's unlikely. So let's just be content with what we got here. We picked up another 8 keys. So we're gonna be at 21. Which is effectively, like, one doubling less than I'd like here, but it is what it is. We gotta keep Blank Card Yera just to Yera the chests. Maybe we can get just a crazy room that has, like, 4 key drops on it. If we can skip, like, 2 doublings, that actually allows us to get to that endgame condition a lot faster. And Blank Card Yera, I'm so glad we got it, because it's the ultimate synergy. Everybody loves to see Blank Card Yera. Gives us a good chance to be able to fight Mega Satan if that's the kind of thing you're into. Good chance of getting weird-ass synergies. I'm not feeling so bad about my damage now that I'm fighting a boss and just destroying them. Alright, up to the cathedral. So this floor is all about Blank Card Yera key farming if possible. Now the ideal room for us would be like a Justice card drop with a battery. Like a battery charge, a little charge. If we could get one of those... Oh yeah, we need you to pay out. This could be good. If we could get one of those, it would just be ridiculous. So if he drops keys, don't pick them up. We can also double whatever the hell else he drops on the ground, which would be awesome. Please don't pay out yet. There's a bomb. That's alright. One doubling of that starts to add up. There we go. Now we get a bomb and a key every 4 rooms. Or our first 4 rooms, then we, you know, get exponential. Red heart, probably not going to be that valuable, but it's something. If we get Dark Bomb or something like that. Oh, that could be a Yera rune right there. Just gives us one extra doubling. Wheel of Fortune, huh? So here's what we do with that. Start playing both of these bad boys at the same time. Trying to get even more consumable drops. A little bit less than I would have hoped for. I'm going to pick it up. Mystery Sack. Let's exit here, see what our rune is. Awaz rune. Could give us a crawl space, did not, that's okay. Let me get this straight, I would prefer... Oh, let's see what this is, Justice, High Priestess. I would prefer to not double this room and double a different room instead right now, but this is okay for now, because it's so early in the floor, we can get our advantage out of this, I think. That's Bob's Rotten Head, I guess. Let's use this for no reason, because we have Epic Fetus. I'll go to our curse room, because why wouldn't I at this point? Usually average one there. Guppy's Tail, alright. Alright, so that means we're not going to be able to easily get off for free without even using keys. Like, we can't even start doubling iron chests because in all likelihood, they're all going to be golden chests now. I should go back for the HP. Oh, we got an Eternal Heart there. Yeah, I should really go back for the HP now. What do you think? Should we just double these? Nah, we'll just open it up instead. Guppy? Not quite Guppy. I don't really care about not doubling the red hearts. Might be nice to keep one around. As long as we only take one from the pile, then there's always, like, there's a renewable source here. Would love a spirit heart, though. You're not wrong about that one. That was very smart. Yeah, really good way to lose your eternal heart there. Just play chicken with the fucking troll bomb. There's already two keys on the other room, so we're just gonna take those two right there. Like, the other room is more attractive because it has the bombs associated with it as well. This is basically what I'm thinking, is we can get keys out of these. Good. We lost one key to open a lot there. I don't feel that bad about that. Maybe we should have left those keys in the ground before picking them up, but you understand my reasoning, I think. You're still alive, huh? Two more keys here. I mean, these keys are meaningless. If only we could get like a 48-hour energy pill or something like that. That is a huge boon for us, but we'll come back down here. If I get to like 32 keys is like the first indicator that we can really get pretty much all we want to get here. Like, we can get 32 items in the chest. But it would be awesome. That's not Guppy either. It would be awesome if we could get 64. And if we get to 64, it's only one more doubling to get to 99. Alright, at least these monsters are dying in one hit. My brain's getting a little cross-wired here thanks to all this math. You know, all this very, very intense mathematics that we've got going on. Alright, so we'll take all this. I'm not gonna sweat using one key or two keys or whatever to open the golden chest that we get on this floor. Yes, it's probably smarter for us to wait on it and use them on the next floor when our keys are guaranteed to give us items, but it doesn't matter that much because one key, once we get into like the real doublings, is basically meaningless. I'm only doing this room at this point. I fucking hate this room. I'm only doing this room because it gives me another charge on our Yara rune. Technically our blank card, you know what I mean though. Just started hitting myself and then walking into these fucking things. We don't even have a black heart or anything. It just sucks to have to, like, seek out the last ones. Thank God we got all this money. Well, if we get money equals power, I'll be happy. Let's just not die on this room. It's deceptively difficult, man. Oh. Okay, are you the last one? No, you're the last two alive. The health bar just keeps going up, man! Ed. My friend. Fuck your room here, man. Oh, it's the worst. Oh, Jesus, it's over. We got a troll bomb. Beautiful. Well, at least we're gonna live. At least for one more room. I'm not the biggest fan of doing my due diligence here for these keys, but it really has to be done. We found our secret room. It has to be done, because if we can pick up 64 or 99 items on the chest, it's just ridiculous. Please let me go, though. Oh, that's great. Okay, so that's actually huge for us. So when we finish our next room, we can actually get two charges. Thank you, dead dry baby. Much appreciated. So this will take us from 4 keys to 8 keys, then 8 keys to 16 keys, which takes us over that 32 key threshold. Now we've only got to do like one more doubling. Two more doublings maybe, and we get to 64. Let's try not to walk on any of these on the way out. Not that the bombs really matter that much, but I'd really rather not walk on the keys. Because every key, you know, in 5 doublings, we basically cost ourselves like 16 keys. Yeah, 5 doublings, because 5... 2 to the power of 5 is 32, right? Yeah. Alright. That's the underlying, you know, mental arithmetic I'm rolling with in the background here. If we have to walk over some spikes to pick this stuff up, it doesn't really matter because we're doubling enough red hearts. The red hearts are one doubling behind. Ooh. Tammy's head, huh? Not immediately worth anything. 2 Yara runes. You can't Yara rune a Yara rune, just for the record. But what we can do is come back in here. This is actually a huge help for us. Can Yara ruin that? And that doesn't take us to 99 keys yet. But it's definitely taking us up to the area where that's going to be doable. So that's why I wasn't worried about opening those golden chests. Because you can open a golden chest and effectively get 32 fucking keys out of it. That's pretty good. We'll keep doubling though, because again, 99 keys is really the be-all end-all for us here. Which means we only need 77. We're probably getting close. It's going to take us like 3 or 4 minutes to pick them all up, I think. Oh my god, that was unexpected. I would sacrifice a lot in the black market if we had some good deals here. And it is a black market. Holy crap. Maybe some batteries? Usually there's like a keybagger or something. Oh, good. Curse of the Blind, I forgot. Alright, tell you what. You know, we'll blow up the keybagger. Can you fuck off forever? I can't kill you, like, just so you know. You might as well just not be a dick about it. There we go. Alright, so I'm thinking... We got invincibility here, let's try it. Little risky. That's okay, now let's start trading some shit away. Deck of cards. Temperance. Temperance comes down. Blow it up. Half a heart. Go play this Demon Judgment. What's this? Telepills. Scares the shit out of me. Alright, let's do it again. Compass. I like it. PhD. I like it. Are we really going to take something that's going to kill us here? No, in case it gives us a spacebar item and fucks up our blank card somehow. I don't know how, but it could. I feel like it could happen. Was this worth it? Probably not. But it was fun. Oh, what do we got there? Bob. I was going to say, it's got to be Bob's brain just to fuck with us. Alright, well, we'll come back and double it. We're not 1, 2, 3, 4. We could have one more doubling before the end of the game. Now it's going to be a problem because I actually do have to walk over the spikes and they would kill me. But we can also just use Epic Fetus to project all the, or propel all the items to us. I'm scared. I'm scared of what's going to happen the next time I double that room. But first things first, we should be scared of the fact that we... Oh, you know what? We should actually just pick up the shit because I want to be able to use the Yara rune immediately on the chest. That's true. We got to strike a balance here. All right. This might only be 32, but I think it's 64 keys. Make sure we're getting it all. Notice I didn't say as much of it as we can. We're going to get it all here. 58 keys. I don't think we're... Well, we're definitely not going to hit 99. But we're going to be close enough that we could probably find enough keys on the next floor to get us to 100. Get us to 99. And we got to 99 bombs. So now we got to beat the rest of the cathedral, but predominantly the difficult part is going to be beating Isaac without taking any damage at all with Bob's brain. So we definitely put ourselves in like nightmare mode here. But I like to live dangerously. Bob's brain is the real piss off. Like, get ready for Bob's brain to have its name cursed to high fucking heaven. Good, 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 good. Dime is meaningless. Okay, we're not gonna immediately have a charge on the next floor. My bad. Let's do this. Okay, land Bob's brain, please. Thank you. Watch out for these crickets' body shots coming in here. Gotta take care of the minions, because it's their shots that are the biggest fuck yous. Alright, I think we're actually going to make it through here just fine. This makes me feel a lot better about our chances for success on this run. Okay, we're just going to hide up in this top right corner. And we should be totally okay. No problems. Alright, down to the next floor. Now, we can't start opening shit immediately. That's the piss off, but it's okay. We can't open anything. Like, again, if we open, like, one chest, it slows us down by, like, a hugely disproportionate factor. There's an extra spirit heart for us to get here, which I'm pretty excited about. That might actually be all we need to actually survive on this run and to win. I'm hoping, at least. Mega Fatty? 2 hits on Mega Fatty. 3 hits on Mega Fatty, but just barely. If we could kill Mega Fatty in 2 hits, we can probably kill him in 2 hits with a Bob's Brain hit. Fuck, we might be able to kill him in 2 hits with a Dry Baby hit. Oh, that's big. We don't need to double it. I think we'll open these chests, but we'll double the golden ones. Because we start like 2 doublings ahead, because we start at 4 there. 1 doubling ahead, I guess, technically. Hoping for a Dark Bum would pretty much guarantee us the win if it's not already guaranteed, which is debatable, I guess. So we'll go back and double it. That'll take us from 8 to 16. Let's not open up any of these by accident if we can avoid it. Hoping one of these is Dad's Key so we can go fight Mega Satan. Next doubling will be to 32. Polycephalus goes down in 1 hit. I would love it if we had Polyphemus, but a little bit of a taller ask. Oh, come on. You're dead. Thank you. I'll open these. That's not going to fuck up our key situation too much. I sort of promise. 1 hit. 2 hits. So we got Aquarius. And did we get Scorpio? Is that why we got poison shots? I thought it was Virgo, but I wasn't really paying attention, admittedly. All right, full health. Maybe useful after we start opening these chests. The quarter, similarly, not immediately useful, but this one's probably never going to be useful. Whole different ball of wax there. Don't open these bad boys yet. Hoping for... Well, I was hoping for some spirit arts. Probably shouldn't have killed Gluttony first. This will be 32 golden chests. After 32 comes 64. Bloat not quite dead in 1 hit. Ah! Close enough. This is good. Anti-grav, I don't even know how that works for us here. Celtic Cross is actually awesome because it's, oh, that was easy. Celtic Cross is awesome because when we have the invincibility, we have Turdy Touch and we have Midas Touch. So we can just walk into enemies. We were already doing enough damage that that's not super relevant, but you get the idea. Not really going to do anything with that. With 64, we could open the chest, but why would we open the chest when instead we could not open the chest? Do you ever think about that? And then we could wait. We might as well, like, open 80 is my thinking. That's going to be 64. So there's going to be a lot of unopened chests the next time we get through here, but... we'll also be able to pick up 80 items in the process. That's like a third of the items in the fucking game, so I think we'll probably be fine if we do that. And it doesn't look like we're going to be able to get too many more doublings anyway, so... Might as well enjoy it while we got it, you know? HP up, that's meaningful. Number one, we'll see if our tears ups actually affect us. I don't think they do. Oh, you know what? It actually seems like it's a lot faster to drag the item around. Or like to drag the crosshair around. Money equals power, huge for us, obviously. I have no idea how chocolate milk works here, but I picked it up anyway. That half heart is good. Look at me being a badass. I don't care. You think I need a half heart interval? Shit, no. I'm sorry, I swore. Don't tell my mom, please. All right, one more key, actually valuable. So we're not gonna be able to open it all, but let's start doing it anyway. Secret room is down here. Key beggar? Wouldn't matter, I guess. I'd just blow him up for more keys. All right, let's start opening this shit up. I don't even know what to say. Look, there's some awesome items in here. I'm not sure if you've noticed. Literally, like, I like how all of the, all of the Zodiac items are, like, right next to one another. We've dropped Blank Card to pick up Monster Manuel. I see Polyphemus. I saw Proptosis. I see Dad's Key. Oh, get Dad's Key quickly. Dad's Key. Dad's Key, come to me. Miter's good. Dad's Key. We did it. Cricket's Head. Polyphemus. Blank Card. Could have just yared the shit out of this again. It seems ridiculous. Okay, we're out of keys. All right. Let's get as much of this shit as we can, including Mom's Knife, including the Wafer, including all these damage upgrades. Do we even have Epic Fetus shots? Like, is that still what we're shooting here? Yes. Holy Mantle's in here. I don't really care what spacebar item we have. Now, do we have Mom's Knife or Epic Fetus? We have Epic Fetus still. Anemic. Shielded Tears. No idea how that even works for us here. Cursed Eye. Yeah, that's a big one. Pisces. Not so concerned about Prayer Card, honestly. We should get... Dark Bomb's a big get for us. I'm concerned about our survivability right now. We only have every item in the game. Crystal Ball, we should just use once. What's our card? We'll never know. Alright, get SMB Superfan in there. We got Isaac's... Oh, we have Isaac's Hard Blood Rites as well. Give me Holy Mantle, thank you. Give me Eve's Mascara, please. I'll also take Blood of the Martyr, if you don't mind. Okay, we're not missing that many passives. I see, like, $3 bill in there, Satanic Bible. This is good, this is good, this is good. We got Blood Rites. Let's go. We got Isaac's Heart? Yeah, we didn't get SMB Superfans, so be it. The Taurus just immediately worked for us, because my speed stat is so high, apparently. All right. This should be fun. I'm actually using two hands to play Isaac here. One on the spacebar, one on WASD. Because Blood Rites with Isaac's Heart. See, there you go. I've always been disparaging, being like, how often do you get Blood Rites, Isaac's Heart? All you need is Blank Card, Yara Rune, and 80 keys, and then you stand a pretty good chance to actually make it happen here. I'm not sure if you noticed. But this should be a pretty easy way for us to come away with the win here. I don't know, I'm a little skeptical of its long-term chances, but it's looking pretty okay right now. Not sure if you've noticed. Alright, so there's one phase of Isaac done. I wish you could use the Yara Rune to double enemies. That's the next step. And then we'll just make even more blood fall from the walls. And you can just see him dying in real time. I'll even try to tap it out a little faster. It's going to be a little noisy here. There you go. There's your blank card, Yara Rune, Mega Satan kill, you freaking lucky so-and-sos. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.